this tutorial, we will see how we can make a square grid mosaic portrait. Go to File and Open. Search for the image that you want to use and open it. When you want to use the same image as in the video, you can find the download link in the video description. Zoom out a bit by holding the Ctrl key and rolling the mouse wheel. In the toolbox, we click on the Measure tool. Check the option Vertical. Click and draw a vertical line in the image, parallel on a line that you want to be exact vertical, like so. When the line is drawn, we can still move the begin and or the end point. Now hit the button Straighten. Make the crop tool active. We will make the image square. Check fixed at the aspect ratio and fill in 1:1. Click and draw a square in the image. With the corners and the handles we can make corrections. And by click and drag inside the cutout we can move the whole cutout. When it looks good, we click in the image or hit enter to confirm. Make the color picker active. Zoom in to the sunglasses and click on a medium pink color. Then press Ctrl-Shift-J to fit the image in the window. Press Ctrl-Shift-N to open the new layer dialog box. Name it Grid. The mode should be normal. And the fill type Transparency. Then hit OK. Go to Filters in the menu bar, click on Render, Pattern and Grid. For this image we make the width 290 and when we press the Enter key the height changes proportional. Make the line width 8. Click and hold the arrowhead at the right bottom of the window to move the image like so. Now zoom in to the corner. Then we go back to the width and click several times on the upper arrowhead until the lines touch the edge of the image. When this looks good, we click OK in the dialog box. Press Ctrl-Shift-J to fit the image in the window. Make the fuzzy select tool active. Click on the second mode button, which is Add to Current Selection. Make sure that the option Select Transparent Areas is checked. It's always a good idea to compare all the tool options with the ones in the video and not only the ones that are mentioned. Now select multiple squares, like shown in the video. When this is done, we drag the white from the background color into the image. Press Ctrl-Shift-A to deselect. Then we select some more squares, more or less like so. Press Ctrl-Shift-N to make a new layer. Name it Pink. And by lack of a pink tag, we choose the purple tag. Then we change the mode to Overlay. This mode mixes the colors while preserving the highlights and shadows. Make the fill transparent. Now hit OK. Drag the pink from the foreground color into the image. Make the opacity of this layer about 60. In the Layers panel, we select the grid layer. Now press Ctrl-Shift-A to deselect the selection. With the fuzzy select tool still active, we select multiple squares that we haven't already colorized. Press Ctrl-Shift-N again. This time we name the new layer Green. And we click on the green color tag. Then we hit OK. Click on the foreground color of the foreground background colors to bring up the color palette. If necessary, we can move it out of the way. Add the HTML notation we fill in 5, 5, D, D, 2, and 7. Hit Enter. We now have a bright green color. Drag this green from the current old preview pane into the image. Adjust the opacity to about 40. Make the grid layer active again. And press Ctrl+Shift+A to deselect. And again, we select several squares in the image that we haven't selected before. Then we hit Ctrl+Shift+N and we name this layer Blue. Click on the blue color tag and then on the OK button. Now we fill in the HTML notation 0, 0, 7, 9, F, F. Hit Enter. And drag the blue into the image. Reduce the opacity of this layer also to about 40. Click on the grid layer and press Ctrl+Shift+A to deselect the selected squares. Select the last, not colored squares, but we can also leave some of the squares to their original color. For the last time, now we press Ctrl+Shift+N. Name it orange and choose the orange color tag. Then hit OK. In the color palette we fill in F, F, A, 3, 2, E. Hit Enter. Drag the orange color into the image. Now we can close the color palette. Make the opacity about 60. Click the portrait layer active and press Ctrl+Shift+A to deselect. Now we can easily apply this effect to any photo we like by just replacing the image. Go to File, Open as Layers, and open the second image. Make the Unified Transform tool active. Make the image opacity about 60. And under Constrain, we check the option Scale. The proportions will now stay intact while we scale the image. Turn off the bottom layer by clicking its eyeball. Then click in the image and zoom out a bit. By click and drag the handles at the sides, the top and the bottom, we can scale the image. And when we click and drag inside the framework, we can move the whole image. When it looks good, we can click Transform. Back to File again and to Open as Layers. Open the third image. And make the second image invisible. Because the Unified Transform tool is still active, we can just click in the image. Scale and move this image. Then hit Transform. We can always adjust each individual color layer depending on the used image. And there we have it, a nice colorful square grid portrait. I hope that you have fun with this tutorial. Please do not forget to like, subscribe and comment. Thanks very much for watching.